Welcome back to my channel, The Flower Buoy here. Author, mother, mompreneur, coach, minister, all of those things. And today I want to talk about self-made. So I rarely get a chance to chill and do nothing or just to Netflix and chill. But with the stay at home or safer at home, everything that's going on right now, over the weekend I had a chance to watch Self-Made. And for those of you who don't know, Self-Made is, kind of the story of, well, not kind of, it is a story about Madam C.J. Walker. And it's told kind of from the perspective of her, but I know that her great-granddaughter had a lot of input in telling her story. Now, some of the people that were in there was, of course, Octavia Spencer. She played Madam C.J. Walker, and then there were some other big-name people in there as well, and some newcomers. So all in all, I really enjoyed it. I mean, it was such an inspiration to see the things that she overcame, from self-image issues to marriage and relationship issues to rejection to not being accepted, to being, there were just so many things, and time after time after time after time, she kept pushing. She kept pushing, and she was able to overcome all that objection and rejection. She was able to literally leave a legacy for her family, for her daughter, which was such a beautiful thing. She was able to become, pretty much the first female self-made millionaire. And back in those times, that was a task. So I really enjoyed the film. I enjoyed the actors, the way they put the story together, the plots, how everything just came together and really painted this picture. I really felt like I was back in the late 1800s and the early 1900s. And so it was a really great film. Now, the only thing that caused me to just really think and self-reflect on my own life, because I've been through some of these things as an entrepreneur, as a mompreneur, as a wife, was that sometimes we as women, or, just an entrepreneur in general, it could be a male too, sometimes we put our own goal before our family, before our marriage. And so in the story, Madam Walker was married 3 times, I believe. And C.J. Walker, I believe, was her last husband, and that's how she got the name Madam C.J. Walker. And let's see. It appeared like her and C.J. had a really good marriage. They had a really good relationship. After she had gone through so much and, being left by her previous husband after he got out of jail and, so many things. However, through the story, we see where her passion for her business outgrew the passion for her marriage. Her passion to, get rich, her passion to build this legacy, it overshadowed the passion to love and to appreciate her husband. And I'm only saying this because I know that there's so many, I've seen so many reviews, so many people saying all this great stuff. And don't get me wrong, I'm truly encouraged by everything that she did. I'm truly encouraged by every obstacle that she was able to overcome, by everything that she was able to do. However, at the end of the movie, my heart hurt. My heart hurt to see that, after she, after her kidneys started to fail and things like that, she only had her daughter, and her daughter was already living her life. And I know she had, the assumed adopted daughter as well. I forget her name from off the top of my head, but it's like, in the end, it's like, was it worth it? Was all the money worth not having, not having somebody to truly share it with, not having someone you can trust? Now, in the movie, we all know, so hopefully you've seen, I keep saying movie, but it's a miniseries. We know that CJ cheated. CJ cheated with one of her sales ladies, And I forget her name too, because I'm only focused on this. But you know, CJ Cheetah, who was one of her top sales reps, and you know, they tried to start their own, you know, company, same hair products and stuff like that, but it didn't go anywhere. But if the movie is true to how her and CJ's relationship really was, I believe that Madam Walker had time to save her marriage. If she would have put her marriage first, before the money, before her goals. Now, I'm definitely not saying that in your marriage you should completely disappear, that you shouldn't have identity, that you shouldn't have personal goals, visions, and things like that. But what I am saying is that when you're married, you create that covenant between you, your spouse, and God. And so in marriage, there's order. There's God, your spouse, and then everything else falls up under that. And if the series depicts what truly happened, there were times when CJ didn't feel like a man. There were times when CJ felt left out. There were times when CJ felt like he wasn't important, that her goal, her vision was everything. And me being a wife, and being an entrepreneur, I've experienced some of those things in my own marriage where I was so driven on the things that I wanted that it's like my husband and kids, they were like on the back burner. Now, good thing, Madam Walker's daughter, she was, Aaliyah, she was already, you know, of age. She was grown because she had it from a previous relationship. But I didn't realize the damage that I was doing to my husband, who is supposed to be the head of my household, who's supposed to be my minister, my provider, my protector, all of those things. I didn't realize how much damage I was doing to his ego. I didn't realize it. And so here in this story with Madam CJ Walker, I see so many of us, so many marriages that go through the same thing. And if we as women, if we can just pause for just a moment and not only get the buy-in from our husband, because CJ helped his wife in business. He was in advertising. He did a lot of the ads and stuff like that. He was gung-ho. They upped and moved to a whole nother state. It's like he was in that. But she kept saying, oh, it's my company, my this, my this. It's like, if we're going to be in this thing together, then make sure that he feels that way. Don't exclude your husband out of your dreams, because you may look up and someone else is loving your husband. Someone else is doing those things or making him feel wanted, making him feel needed. Because I have a very strong personality, but I realize that there's so much beauty in submission. There's so much beauty in submission, because if I'm submitting to my husband, then my husband is submitting to God. And it's just this beautiful thing that's going on. But in this situation, as much as we're celebrating the story, and like I said, I'm not putting up any, I'm not hating, I'm not putting any shade. I'm just looking at it from a different perspective, because I've been where she was at. I've been there. I have had my life out of order for periods of time where I was chasing the money. I was chasing the vision. It was all about the hustle and nothing with the flow, because everything that comes from God, it flows, right? And so in everything that you do, be sure that you're respecting your husband. Involve him in your goals. Have those courageous conversations with him. Even as women, in my previous marriage, I was the breadwinner, but I never made my husband feel as if he was not the head of the household. So I encourage you to, as we celebrate the success of Madam CJ Walker, as we celebrate everything that her life represented, all of the good, all of the overcoming, everything that she did, let's also remember that if we are married, if you are a married person, don't put your goals and your visions before your spouse. Don't put your goals and visions before your spouse. And if you had those goals and visions before you made that covenant with your spouse and with God, then that should have been a total responsible conversation or courageous conversation that you guys should have had before you've gotten married, before you got married. So they should know the weight of this goal, of this vision for you, of like what it, the depth and how this thing feels to you. And work that thing out. Just have those conversations. Have open line of communications. But please, wives, respect your husband. And husbands, love your wife. No matter what goals we're going through, you know, no matter what's going on, wives, we should respect our men. And husband, you should love your women. During this time now with the virus going on and the pandemic that the world is in right now, like worldwide, we're all being put on a holy pause. And during this holy pause, I am using this time to do a reset. And I've shared this with a lot of our coaching communities and ministry communities. I'm using this time as a holy reset, a holy pause to do some reset. You know, what in a reset, what happens, LaFlower? Well, in a reset, you're evaluating the relationships, the statuses, the things that's in your life right now. Whether it's your career, whether it's where you worship, whether it's your business, whether it's friendships, whether it's even your marriage, your relationship with your children. Evaluate all of that. And ask yourself, does this relationship or position make me happy? Does it serve my highest good? And if it doesn't, then it may be something that you need to cut off. Maybe something that you don't need anymore in your life. Maybe you're past that phase in your life. Or maybe you need to have a courageous conversation with someone and open up those lines of communication to see what happened. Where did we go wrong? But I encourage you to not come out on the other side of this pandemic the same way that you went in. I encourage you to use this time as a reset period, to use it as an incubation period, to really ask God, if you don't know what your purpose is, really seek that thing. Ask God for wisdom during this time so that you'll come out better than you went in. Now, I'm not going to start preaching to y'all tonight. That'll be another video. But thank you so much for tuning in into my personal, again, this is me. This is just how I think. This is how LaFlower thinks. My personal review of Self-Made. Hopefully you guys took something from it. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, definitely hit that subscribe button. And grace and peace to everybody. Until next time.